Basics of SCADA. Introduction. SCADA stands for Supervisory Control and Data Acquisition. As the name indicates, it is not a full control system, but rather focuses on the supervisory level. As such, it is a purely software package that is positioned on top of hardware to which it is interfaced, in general via programmable logic controllers, PLCs, or other commercial hardware modules. SCADA systems are used not only in industrial processes, for example steel making, power generation and distribution, chemistry, but also in some experimental facilities such as nuclear fusion. Hardware architecture. One distinguishes two basic layers in a SCADA system, the client layer which caters for the man-machine interaction and the data server layer which handles most of the process data control activities. The data servers communicate with devices in the field through process controllers. Process controllers, for example PLCs, are connected to the data servers either directly or via networks. Data servers are connected to each other and to client stations via an Ethernet LAN. Software architecture. The SCADA products are multitasking and are based upon a real-time database located in one or more servers. Servers are responsible for data acquisition and handling, for example polling controllers, alarm checking, calculations, logging and archiving, on a set of parameters, typically those they are connected to. Communications. Server-client and server-server communication is in general on a publish-subscribe and event-driven basis and uses a TCP/IP protocol, that is, a client application subscribes to a parameter which is owned by a particular server application and only changes to that parameter are then communicated to the client application. The products provide communication drivers for most of the common PLCs and widely used field buses, for example, Modbus. Features. It has many special features like access control. They also support the concept of a generic graphical object with links to process variables. These objects can be dragged and dropped from a library and included into a synoptic diagram. It is generally possible to group alarms and to handle these as an entity. The majority of the products allow actions to be automatically triggered by events. A scripting language provided by the SCADA products allows these actions to be defined. Benefits of SCADA. The benefits one can expect from adopting a SCADA system for the control of experimental physics facilities can be summarized as a rich functionality and extensive development facilities. The amount of specific development that needs to be performed by the end user is limited, especially with suitable engineering. These systems are used for mission-critical industrial processes where reliability and performance are paramount. In addition, specific development is performed within a well-established framework that enhances reliability and robustness. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, and subscribe channel for more educational video. Have a nice day.